I am Travis County Commissioner for Precinct 2 for a couple more days. I recently resigned that position so that I could run for Travis County Judge because Travis County and urban counties in Texas are at a crossroads. I did not take the decision to leave a job that I have loved lightly. But we do need leadership with experience, courage, and heart to lead an urbanized county that has a population growing as fast as ours is and inequities dividing us at a more rapid pace than I think any Democrat should tolerate. Achieving political office is not my goal. Just going to say that up front. Achieving good government is my goal. I have a deep investment in this community and in having good county government. My family's from here. My mother, two sisters, and a brother still live and work here, even though I'm from a family of six. My husband and I are raising two kids here. My kids go to public school. Two of my sisters teach at ACC, and I teach at the University of Texas. Before becoming a commissioner, I was a Travis County attorney, an assistant Travis County attorney, for 8 years. In my 14 years of public service with the county, I have written, passed, and defended policy in almost every area of county government. This new job that I'm seeking is going to be a real challenge. But I do have the experience to get the job done. I also have the courage to stand up to some powerful interests who would keep us from getting the job done effectively, efficiently, and fairly. And I also have a real passion to find the solutions that county government is in desperate need of. I am a public servant by nature and not a politician. I'm born of public servants. My father, Congressman Bob Eckhart, gave 60 years of public service, and 24 of those were as an elected official. Whether in office or not, he was a tireless supporter of workers, consumers, and the environment. He also was a stalwart defender against abuse of power. He worked hard representing unions and writing, passing, and defending the Open Beaches Act, Superfund, the War Powers Act, to name a few. But my mother, Nadine Eckhart, is no less a public servant. She never held elective office, but she did work for two legislators, a U.S. Senator by the name of Lyndon Johnson, the Public Utilities Commission, the Older Women's League, and Molly Ivins. And when she and my father divorced, she actually put in her divorce petition a claim to half of this congressional office. And my father responded in writing, in his response to her petition for divorce, that she absolutely deserved half the congressional office, that he did not contest that, and he wished that he could give it to her. I am seeking to become the Travis County Judge, the first female Travis County Judge, because this job is the chief executive of county government. Of the 48 separate elected officials in Travis County government, there is no other position that has a broader influence to create good, solid, efficient, effective, and fair county government. The Travis County Judge presides over the Commissioner's Court, making decisions affecting roughly 1 million people, 5,000 Travis County employees, an $800 million budget, and 1,000 square miles of territory. So as an example of what we face in county government, I'm going to walk you through a specific issue that's been kind of hot in the news these days. But I think it will illustrate why we need leadership that has experience, courage, and heart. The state doesn't give county governments much authority. Y'all, I think, all know this. The state requires us to provide jails, courts, and roads. But it doesn't give us much authority to do much else besides jails, courts, and roads. But in an urbanized county like ours that is growing as fast as ours, where the areas outside the city of Austin are actually growing faster than the city of Austin itself, which is outstripping all other cities in the nation practically, this kind of limited authority is creating some deep, deep inequities in our community. In emergency services, as an example, if you have a house fire, a heart attack, or a major wildfire, if it occurs inside the city limits, you are going to get excellent emergency response. You are likely to get both an ambulance and a fire truck at your front door in less than 9 minutes. But if you have a heart attack out at East Metro Park while watching your son's soccer game, or if you have a car wreck on Hamilton Pool Road, you're going to wait a considerably longer amount of time for a response. This is because, under state law, emergency responses outside the city of Austin are the responsibility of the county? No. They're the responsibility of 13 separate emergency service districts that are established by state law and in state law are capped at 10 cents per $100 valuation. They're independent taxing authorities that are kept at an extremely low property tax rate that is utterly inadequate to respond to an urbanizing population outside the city of Austin. What the state has given us is a wildly ineffective, inefficient, and unfair system. 13 separate departments, even if they had an adequate revenue stream, couldn't possibly achieve maximum effectiveness or efficiency. So the county, through its EMS interlocal with the city of Austin, and the Austin Fire Department, subsidize the activities of the emergency service districts in order to provide fairness to all Travis County residents. But here's the thing. With a 10-cent property tax with the ESDs, this fractured system creates a serious inequity. Wealthier parts of the county get more revenue off of 10 cents per $100 valuation. Anybody know what the average property value is in the Eanes School District? $600,000. Yeah, Tina knows. Tina, what's the average property value in the Del Valle School District? Probably about 10% of that. That's the kind of deep inequity that we're talking about. So what's the solution? ESDs and small cities within them could delegate their authority to the county to run a county-wide emergency services response system. They could delegate their 10 cents property value. And then the county undoubtedly would have to continue to subsidize that to some degree. But that subsidy, that additional increment provided by the county, would at least be coming from every one of the 23 municipalities and villages in Travis County in proportion to their property value, so that we could achieve an effective, efficient, and equitable system that provides services to all. This would create a countywide system that, for the first time, even the poorest areas of Travis County would receive the same level of service as anyone else in Travis County. So here's where experience, courage, and heart come in. Whether it's emergency services, transportation, environmental protection, or affordable housing, we will only find solutions through leadership with knowledge. Staff can only get you so far. You need a leader with knowledge who will take you over the finish line. We will only find solutions through leadership with courage. There are powerful interests at play. The state, other counties, cities, unions, they all have interests, and they will vigorously defend them. So we need a leader with the courage to vigorously defend the interests of Travis County. Without that, we won't have balance among these interests, and we will pay more, and we will get less. We will only find solutions through leadership with heart. Building and maintaining good county government takes commitment to a longer game than most political cycles. Good government is always good politics, but good politics is not necessarily good government. The county judge is a position that requires administrative and policy know-how. And to put it in perspective, the decisions that the commissioner's court makes in administration and in policy move more money in 2 days than the Travis County Democratic Party has raised in 4 years. 2 days. I have the knowledge, courage, and heart to solve these issues that we face collaboratively. I will be here to do the work today. I will be here to do the work tomorrow for all of Travis County residents. I will not be scared off by powerful interests, and I will not abandon the least among us. I'm a public servant, and I serve Travis County. Thanks.